Okay, so another interesting addition is we get to see some gaps filled, or a gap filled, for the Chinese ground forces tree with the addition of the antelope, or what they're calling the antelope. I don't actually think this vehicle is officially called the antelope. I believe it's the system, the SAM itself, that is referred to as an antelope. I'm not actually sure what the vehicle is called, but it's basically a new SAM for Chinese ground forces, this being a Taiwanese unit. That will fit, I think, between the PGZ-04A and the Tor M1, and is nice to see because people are always wanting to see more SPAA, and you know what I say every time is it's great to have more options, but this doesn't exactly fix or solve the issue of combined battles, the balance, the immensely horrid balance issues that occur in ground forces. But let's take a closer look at a new vehicle for the Chinese ground forces. So this is one of the most advanced short-range anti-air systems for the Chinese. It's the Antelope, a self-propelled anti-aircraft vehicle, rank 7. At a glance, it has access to anti-jam homing missiles, although only 4 in total. What the hell? A thermal imager and virtually no armor to speak of course, because it's a freaking truck. And here is some history, or van, I guess, on the unit. Not much to go for there, but they do show it in a handful of camouflages. Here is a tricolor paint. And here is just the straight Taiwanese sort of dark green paint, which always looks nice. So this is joining the top ranks of the tree, offering quite a unique playstyle and allowing for a smoother transition between the PGZ-04A and Tor M1, where there was previously a sizable gap. The Antelope is the second missile-only platform to arrive to the Chinese Ground Forces tree, arriving or leaving conventional weapons behind. The Antelope features an integrated missile launcher with 4 IR-guided SAMs on board. Unlike the missiles found on the preceding PGZ-04A, or 04A, the Antelope's armament features much greater range, up to 8 kilometers. As a result of this range and the general drastic improvement of the missile itself, its ability to intercept aircraft is very impressive. However, a limitation of the Antelope is that it can only carry a max of 4 missiles with no room to store any extra. What you see is what you get, so make every launch count. That is tragic. 4 missiles is all you get on this thing, and that's it. I mean, you have to basically sit on a point if you want to really be super effective with this thing, but you better hope that, you know, it's, I like how it says make every shot count, but really you just have to hope that your shot even works. You only do so much with a SAM. You basically just have to find a target to lock, pick the right target, and then launch and hope that it doesn't avoid the missile or have the missile be intercepted by some sort of countermeasure or something like that. That's basically all you have to hope for, and you only have 4 chances of hoping that at the same time. So being on a modified truck chassis, the Antelope boasts excellent mobility thanks to its 150 horsepower diesel engine. The vehicle can reach a top speed of just shy of 100 kilometers an hour. This makes it very easy to reposition itself after firing. A key element to SPAA is surprise, so engaging from an unexpected position will grant a much higher chance of success. Only sucks that aircraft can see absolutely fucking everything from way the fuck up high, thanks to vehicles being unbelievably easy to spot at high altitudes in a game like this, just because of the way that everything is modeled. Especially if the radar is kept off until the last moment. The speed can also be effectively utilized to head to friendly strategic points to replenish missiles, though can be very careful out in the open as the Antelope is entirely unarmored. Yes, so a tiny machine gun burst, even the smallest machine gun burst from the lightest tank in the game is going to wipe this thing out instantly. I'm assuming its crew is only present in the actual cabin of the vehicle itself rather than anywhere else. So pretty much one and done if you get shot in this thing. But here we've got a few more screenshots. Only so much you can, of course, show with this, but we got a side shot, a nice rear shot. You can see the missiles there. Looks pretty fancy, you know. But yeah, it does suck that you only get 4 missiles on this thing. It would be nice if they added the ammo boxes that I thought were supposed to be coming with the same update, but apparently those have been delayed, I guess. I don't know when those are appearing. The whole idea where you could build like trenches or camouflage nets or put down ammo boxes that people could use, etc. That sounded like a really cool addition. Yeah. Believe it or not, there's stuff I like and ideas I think would be great about this game, you know? As much as I am struggling to see any motivation to want to play this game anymore until certain changes are made, specifically to the mode that I frequent, which is Ground Forces, and its event system, but considering very little has been changed, it's only ever been made worse, for the most part, over the 10 fucking years I've been playing this game, that is something I would like to see, is the whole thing with people being able to support each other with these basically placeables, these buildables. And those ammo boxes might be great for a vehicle like this. Somebody can place one down and you can resupply some of your missiles. I don't know exactly how it'll work, but it just sounds like that would be really useful. But anyways, it's still nice to see some further SPAA options for China, and well, now we've got that. This particular vehicle should hopefully provide some help. I mean, it does say smoother transition, but at the same time, you're transitioning into something with a very limited amount of ammunition. The great thing about the PGZ-04A is that while its missiles aren't fantastic or anything, it has 4 really good autocannons fixed on it. And the Tor is supposedly has fantastic missiles, of course, but it loses those autocannons. So you go from having a great versatility with its weapons to something that has only 4 missiles and that's it, to something that has great missiles but and more of them. So transition, I don't necessarily know if it's a smooth transition, but it at least gives you something else to unlock and play with while you're working your way down the tech tree. It'll give you an additional SPAA option. Because it's not just one per tier, it's one that you can add to your lineup where you might have your previous SPAs also present.